the Gallagher boys are back. Oasis perform their new track on Top of the Pops in half an hour. They're on BBC One.
A lineup of fast movers and shakers. But first, a couple of schmoozers and fakers. It's the captains, Matt and Ali. And joining Ali tonight is a Liverpool footballing great and a flying winger from Wales.
Just senseless surprise for Wales and just devastation for Scotland. Wales are taking the penalty and Scotland slipping, and it's Rhys Williams for the corner.
Wisp made the chance well for himself, and it's there, put forward beautifully by Phil Thompson.
And there it is, the smile of the season, the performance of the season, the trophy of the season.
Please welcome Rhys Williams and Phil Thompson. Hero and a record-breaking athlete from South Africa.
Oscar Pistorius is flying away from all of them. This is remarkable. He's going to win out of his classification. 21.99, my goodness.
He absolutely tore down the track and became Paralympic champion here in Athens.
Please welcome Oscar Pistorius and Peter Reid. Now, the picture board may be a close shave this week because all the pictures feature some sort of facial hair. All I want to know is who are behind the goatee beards, moustaches and the mutton chops. So, Phil, we're going to ask you to pick a number first.
I got stitched up on last time because I went for the number that I played in. So I'm going for something different. Go for number 8.
You know us too well on this programme.
I'm happy with him. I'm just tasting him. He's got it. We've got it.
Sam Torrance.
Ryder Cup winning player and captain. 2 points. Peter.
I'm number 2, please.
Bad selection, Mr. Reid.
It's not good.
I'll leave that one to you, Oscar.
Oh, man.
He's got to be South African, isn't
he? No.
I'm joking.
No, I'll tell you who it might be.
Oh! Hold on a minute. Oh, it's a good shout. All right, what do you think, Tom?
Well, I think I've guessed right.
You reckon?
You did. I think it's him.
That's just put a little bit of pressure on us now, isn't it?
I'll tell you what, if you get her, you'll be doing well. I think you're right. Steve Armisen.
You're right, yeah. Well done.
Move on.
Rhys, you're good.
Number 7, please.
Yes.
Yeah. Is it Eric Cantona?
Manchester United's French legend, yes. Yes, well done. Over we go to Oscar. Okay.
I'll take number 11.
Brian Fraser. Have you got a goatee?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Brian Fraser.
Confident. I'm happy with that.
Yeah, goes Brian Fraser.
American Paralympic sprinter. Oh, you are right. Yes. Well done. Had that, did you, Alex?
Had it written down. Not sure about spelling, you know, but
Raven's got it. Got it.
Ali, your go.
Number three, please. Oh, of course it is.
That is a
he was a doctor, wasn't he?
Yeah. Still is.
Still is.
That's how good he was. He used to treat himself if he got injured. Well, he was. JPR Williams.
It is, yes. Former Wales and Lions fullback. Matt didn't get a full health.
I would like to choose number six, please, Susan.
Pleasure, Matthew.
Oh, come on.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on.
Mind game.
Yes. Please.
Yeah.
Not, not one of them, is it?
Come on, Reader.
Reedy, there's a complete lack of input for you over there, I'll tell you.
I've got to say, I'm having one at the minute.
Shut up, you. Leave it out. Doesn't look anything like a horse. Come on.
You think I should get it?
Looks like you've got a collar shirt on.
You played one.
Oh, don't listen. It's a word he said. Really impulsive liar.
Quite close to home.
Oh, come on. Who? Legends. Tashes. Sooness. Do you have a Tash? McDermott. Mick Mills.
It looks like Suey's nose before he had the job done.
Reedy, don't talk about noses while I'm in the country.
By the way, Phil, I know it's not you. I think Suey's a good shout.
There you go. Oh, did you get that all on your own?
No, you said it.
Well,
I'll go with that. Go ahead.
We'll go with Stewie.
Graham Sooner? It is, oh, yes.
We can't send you down the wrong track.
I just swore blamed it with Nigel
Mansell.
We were sitting here nice and pretty here.
What's that got to do with Nigel?
I don't know. I was just trying to throw you in where you could.
Former Liverpool and Scotland midfielder gets you the 2 points. So end of the round, the teams are tied, both on six. Now, both pieces of sports action this week have a common theme. And for your job is to spot what connects the five pieces of action. There will also be some additional questions, so as always, make sure you keep an eye on everything that's going on. Ali, your team are up first.
Little swing by Delmar. Tottenham here are making headway. And it's a goal straight away. Almost from the kickoff and inside 2 minutes.
Murphy. Justin Bishop. Referee's made his landing. Bishop's got to the line. Terrific score by Justin Bishop.
Okay, questions first. Which Tottenham player did you see scoring against Manchester City in 2004?
Ledley King.
Yes, England international defender. Well done. Which Briton did you see losing in a five-set match in 1986 against Mats Wilander?
Andrew Castle.
Yep, former Davis Cup player. So, what's the theme for sports action?
Chess. Thank you.
Yes. It is. Well done. Thought we might have thrown you there because we had King Castle, Justin Bishop, Nick Knight and...
Switzer.
And Berger are checkmates.
Oh, brilliant. Checkmates.
Matt, over to your team. Once again, there's something linking all of these pieces of action, and other questions will follow.
Come away again to win the World Championships with a brilliant piece of running.
Gets a tremendous in swing in the open. And Pakistan away to rather a grisly start.
Josh Lucy, Danny Grucock out there. Good pass, Grucock to Josh Lucy. Fantastic work by England.
You saw Josh Lucy scoring a try for England against Italy, but in which year did Italy join the tournament to take it from five to six nations?
That's a joke, that one.
It's got to be. That wee man there is just ready to pounce on any of errors you make in that team. So he's coming for you. That
any of errors.
A caged tiger. Ready to pounce on your errors. This wee man here. Stay in your cage, pal. I think it was 2000.
Well done,
oh,
yes.
Marvelous.
Which athlete did you see taking gold in the T44 200 metres at the World Championships in Paris back in 2003?
Marlon Chenu.
It was, yes. Also won a gold medal in the T44 100 Paralympics in Athens. And finally, what's the theme that connects the sports people feature?
Girls' names.
It is, yes. Lucy and Shirley, Peter Alice, Ludovic, Julie and Dennis Lilly were all featured there. So, end of the round, teams still tied, both on nine. Now, but it just might change in this round. This week's observation round looks like the agony and ecstasy of sport. Ali, the collection of sports stars you're about to see know how lonely a packed sports arena can feel when it's just not your day. Remember, you have to watch everything around you in this clip, and the questions will follow.
I just want to inform that commentary was superimposed onto that bit of shit.
You saw Chris Waddle's agony after missing his semi-final penalty, but what number was the German who was the first player to console him?
Number 10.
10, yes. Well done. Mervyn King was agonisingly close to completing a 9-dart finish. Can you tell me how many points he scored with his second dart? In that clip.
57.
Treble 19, yes. Finally.
Here we go. There's always a final one.
Alan Donald was run out, handing Australia a place in the 1999 World Cup final. What I want to know is how many Australian cricketers could you see in that clip?
Yeah, I think you're absolutely spot on.
I'll go with
all of them, 11.
It was, yes. done. Matt, for your team, it's those magic moments that make all the hard work worthwhile. Watch this collection of celebrations closely. Again, question for Colin.
That's the way you do it.
Yes! Britain are through to their first badminton final.
Did you get that? Did you get it? Did you get it?
I think I might have missed one there. Not
Matt, not only did Reedy get it, he's going to reenact it.
About 2 o'clock in the morning.
So first of all, Gail Emms and Nathan Robertson were overjoyed at reaching the Olympic badminton final. What was the score in the winning game?
Oh, it was on the screen.
Yes.
No, well, that wasn't in the stadium, it was on the... How do you win a game of badminton? What score do you have to have?
Badminton?
Is it 21?
No.
No?
15.
15.
Is it 15?
15. Should we say 15? What is one
we've
of them?
Just got to get... We just got to get one score, obviously.
No, you've got to get the score, and it goes on offer, so I can only accept one, I'm afraid.
Why am I thinking of
it? What are you thinking?
I'm
thinking of 11.
Oh, yeah?
Are you guessing?
I'm guessing.
Are you guessing?
Yeah, I'm guessing.
So should we go in between?
Yeah.
Go on, Reedy, you do it.
15-13. No, it wasn't. Goes on offer?
We think it was one less. I think it was 15-12.
It was 15-12. Oh! One bonus point. Now the question Reedy's waiting for. How many flips Julius Agahauer of Nigeria perform in his celebration?
Go with your instinct.
Seven.
Go with your instinct.
It was, yeah. One handspring, five backflips and a backwards somersault. Finally, you saw Kelly Holmes celebrating her second Olympic gold. Did you remember seeing that?
Don't say what was the time, please.
What is the total
five.
Figure when you add up all the digits in Kelly's competition number?
Right, that one.
Yeah, that's it.
Now, we've got to make sure we add this up properly.
40.
What? Go on, then.
It was 18.
It was 18. 1809. Well done, so end of the round. Matt's on 11, Ali's team there in front on 13. So now 1 point for home question, 2 points to go away.
Jack.
Oh, yes.
As you said, we've got our noses in front.
That wasn't nice,
isn't it? We're team captain as well.
You can't even rely on your own team, eh? Phil, your go. Home or away?
This home.
Home question? Who won a League Cup winner's medal this year, 24 years after his father played in a losing final in the same competition?
Frank Lampard.
Yes, his father played for West Ham in 81.
Don't do this to me.
We've got to go away, haven't we?
No, we're behind.
We're 2 points behind,
pal. Go on, Reedy, home or away?
Skipper, I'm going. You're in charge, go on.
No, it's coming out of your mouth. So, you
away.
Know. Hold on, just hold it. He was just talking to me about something.
Okay.
The points then, if we get this wrong, it goes over to the opposition, and that is the end of the game.
You can't back down now, everybody will laugh at you.
Home.
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 Home question.
Yeah.
Who, having played in a Merseyside derby, went on to score an own goal in the Manchester derby this year?
An early side derby. They scored in an
over. Oh, I've got it.
Right.
Centre half.
Who?
I hope it is.
Who?
Richie Thun.
And he scored in the Merseyside derby.
No, he played in it.
Just played, not scored.
Who, having played in the Merseyside derby, went on to score an own goal in the Manchester derby?
Richie Thun.
Correct, yes. Well done. So, Reece, over to you. Home question.
Home, please.
Which former Welsh international this year was the director of rugby in the Leeds side that had their first ever success in England's Premier Club knockout competition?
Phil Davis.
Correct, well, yes. That is Leeds defeated Bath 2012 at Twickenham.
Go ahead.
Go on,
Oscar, home question. Home. Which Australian has won medals at the last four Paralympics, including four golds in Sydney in the T44 200 and 400 metres and both relays? Which Australian?
I was really hoping you weren't going to look to me for advice.
I think it's Neil Fuller.
Correct, yes.
Well.
For the captains this week, we have asked an artist to draw caricatures of some of the most famous faces in sport. All you have to do is buzz in, both of you, or either of you, when you think you know who it is. However, if you buzz in too early and get it wrong, the other team will have the rest of the time and see the whole picture. Okay, here's the first.
Cabrera, is it?
No, it isn't.
Oh. It's the other one's the Spaniard.
Is it coming to me?
Yes. Well, yes.
We got it.
No, not finished yet.
Jimenez.
It's him who?
Jimenez.
Yes, Miguel Angel Jimenez. You're right. Yes, European Ryder Cup star. Well done. Here's number two.
Dennis Matt. Taylor.
Yes, 85 World Super Champion. Here's the third. Matt.
Thorpe.
Ian Thorpe, Australia's swimming superstar. On we go.
It's a big rugby player, Martin Johnson.
England's Rugby World Cup winning captain. Let's see it. Yes. On we go. Matt?
Arsene Wenger.
Arsenal's French manager, yes. I heard Phil spelling. Hey, Phil. Is he a bit slow, though?
Yeah, he was a bit slow, by the way.
I just never understood Tom.
Yeah, that's right.
Anger.
One more to go. Yeah. Yep.
Kelly Holmes.
She's going to love us for that. Yes, let's see it, though. Double Olympic gold medalist. Very good. So, end of the round. Matt's on 16. Ali in front on 18. Okay, Ali, you go first. Who is this recreating Roger Bannister's 4-minute mile?
Up till yesterday, the world record for the mile stood at 4 minutes 1.4 seconds. But as Bannister lined up for a start in this race between the CAs and Oxford University, he knew that he had two colleagues with him who'd help him beat that time. The end of the first quarter-mile lap. Time, 57.4 seconds. They were ahead of the clock. The end of the second lap, and half a mile gone, still ahead of the clock. 250 yards to go, and Bannister takes over. Watch his giant stride take him to the front as he races the last lung-bursting furlong to the finishing post. The tape is broken, and so is the record athletes have long been dreaming about. But at first, Bannister knows little about it. He stumbles into the arms of his coach, completely exhausted by his magnificent effort.
Jockey Richard Johnson.
Let's see. Cheltenham Gold Cup winning jockey, you are right, Richard Johnson. And for Matt's team, who's this catalogue model?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Say that because you managed him.
Thank you, Alex.
Danny Mills.
We'll have to have a look. Yes, England fullback, you're right. Well done, Reedy. Danny Mills. So, end of that round. Matt's on 18, Ali on 20. Finishing on the buzzer this week, and it's a question of national sports. Every country in the world has an official national sport. For example, in Brazil, you won't be surprised to hear it's football. In Estonia, of course, it's cross-country skiing. That's examples. I will give you the name of a country, and all you have to do is buzz in and tell me what their national sport is. Okay? Here we go. Number one, New Zealand.
Rugby union.
It is, yes.
Oh, what, I beat you.
Second, Japan. Greece.
Football.
It's sumo wrestling. It doesn't go on offer, I'm afraid. It's 1 point away. Barbados.
It's got to be cricket.
It is cricket, yes. Pakistan. No guessing?
Hockey.
It is hockey, yes. Cuba.
Alex. Boxing.
Baseball.
It's not, it's boxing, they've changed it. I just got a phone call here. The bag full of cash throw just off the phone.
Austria.
Skiing.
Yes. China.
Table tennis.
Yes. One made the difference. Ali's team, they're the winners. 21 points to 20. So that is it for this week. A big thank you to all of our guests. And don't forget, you'll be able to see Oscar in action in the Paralympic World Cup next Sunday at 3 o'clock on BBC Two. The three of us will be back next week, same time. Bye for now.
Who stays up and who gets relegated? What are your predictions? Match of the Day will have the full picture of the Premiership season tomorrow night at 10:15. Next on BBC One, Top of the Pops.